Darksiders 3 is releasing this month, bringing us one step closer to the ending of the story of the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse. Everything you loved about the franchise is there, the intense hack-and-slash fights, the puzzles, and the terrifying antagonists. There are things, though, that Darksiders 3 is doing different than its predecessors. Let me explain. I'm Wes Malik from SegmentNext, and here are 15 new things in Darksiders 3 that weren't in the previous games. A new protagonist. We've seen death, and we've seen war. Now it's time to follow Fury into her own journey in Darksiders 3. Gunfire Games has promised that her arc is the strongest one in the franchise, and we believe them. The Sister of the Horsemen is set on a journey to defeat and imprison the seven deadly sins. You can tell that this quest will be filled with incredible encounters. The Chain Whip. As with the previous Horsemen, Fury has her own special weapon too, the Chain Whip. With it, you can swing around, destroy obstacles, and deal devastating blows to enemies. Your whole gameplay will be revolving around your whip, so be sure to get the hang of its mechanics early on so that you can master Darksiders 3 effortlessly. Different forms. Apart from a strong storyline, Fury has a cool set of abilities as well. For the time being, we know of two different forms that Fury can switch to, Fire Fury and Force Fury. Both have their own abilities and secondary weapons to pair with our Chain Whip. More skill, less gear. The Chain Whip, though, will be a standard for Fury. As the developers have revealed, Darksiders 3 has shifted its focus more to the abilities of Fury than weapons and armor. That's why you won't be hoarding weapons and armor with different stats throughout the game, but will instead depend on your own fighting and dodging skills. Darksiders has really matured on this aspect. We'll have to see if it's still true to the franchise. New antagonists. In Darksiders 1, you had Abaddon and the Griever and Tiamat. Next up, in its sequel, you had to fight Garn and Karkanos. Darksiders 3 is releasing with yet another big cast of antagonists to fight. In particular, the seven deadly sins are your main foes, each of which is envisioned in its own unique way. Sloth, for instance, is a huge fat pest, and Envy is a weird bird-like looking creature. We can't wait to see all of them in action. More options. In a detailed Q&A in the game's official Discord page, the developers have explained how their new game lets you experience it in whatever order you want. Darksiders is no longer linear, letting you encounter the sins however you want. The layout of the map helps you with that as the transition from one to another happens naturally. We'll discuss more about it later on. Each sin has its own environment. Many fans have been worrying about the map itself and how we haven't seen much of it up until now. In trailers and gameplay videos, we've seen only a couple of settings, making us think that there won't be a variety of them. That's actually not true. Darksiders 3 will have many different environments to explore. Each sin, for instance, will have a few, bringing their nasty character to life. The world is big but different. The developers of Darksiders 3 have revealed that the whole layout of their new game will be nothing like in the previous games. It will be huge nonetheless, but more like in Metroid. We can't wait to see what this means for the franchise. New Game Plus. One more detail that will add replayability to Darksiders 3 is the introduction of New Game Plus. If you happen to love the game and want to invest more time in it, you'll be able to start over in a New Game Plus mode and experience another layer of difficulty in it. Absence of finishing moves. Some may say that this is a bad thing for Darksiders 3. However, Gunfire Games has revealed that they might have removed finishing moves, but fans won't be disappointed. From what we've seen, the game doesn't lack intensity in killing blows, so missing the finishing move element doesn't seem that bad. We'll have to wait for the finished product, though, to see how it holds up at the hands of the players. Multiple endings. Darksiders 3 is leaving the linear gameplay behind. As we mentioned before, you'll be able to assess battles in whatever order you choose. That goes for the endings as well. You won't be getting one ending and will instead be dealing with a choice that will determine how the game ends for you. We don't know, though, how this feature holds up with the story. Setting up the franchise ending. And that's where the previous question results. According to Gunfire Games, Darksiders 3 is setting up the ending of the franchise. You'll see how the stories of the previous games get tied together and create the path to the finishing line. If we do have multiple endings, though, what does this mean for the ending of the franchise? We don't have to worry about it, since the developers are sure that we won't be disappointed with the outcome. Better puzzles. Puzzles are an organic component of the Darksiders franchise. They couldn't be missing from the upcoming game or else it wouldn't be the same. This time around, though, puzzles will be present in a more natural way, merging with the environment. You can say that puzzles now tie one environment to another in a perfect way, and there's something to uncover in each area. Darksiders 3 is releasing on November 27th on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC. The game follows another horseman of the apocalypse into her own personal journey filled with action. Are you excited about its release? Which console are you getting it on? Let us know in the comments below. If you found this video informative, remember to subscribe to SegmentNext for more. Until next time.